It would be the mid-70s, and I was in high school.
75 or 76.
I saw an article on Joe Fafard, and I really liked his work. I loved that he lived on the prairies, and I decided I was going to be Joe Fafard. Yeah, I wanted to be a sculptor at first. I had my first solo show in 1980 when I was about 18 years old. A reporter came and interviewed me and said something to the effect of that I was Métis, and I was like, what? And had never heard that word before. Look around you, this is a native gallery. Kind of a surprise, because it was just the kind of art that I was interested in, and it was a gallery in the neighborhood. So my trajectory was shaky at the beginning. I was always interested in art. I was making these sculptures. I was making strange mobiles.
The ceiling was covered with
mobiles. My mom painted and was a wonderful painter, and I didn't want to be stepping on her toes and trying to do something she was doing. But eventually, yeah, that's where I had to go. I met my partner Sylvia Zeman, who's also an artist in art school. Went out to Nova Scotia for a while, and Nova Scotia College of Art and Design. Got introduced to theory, and it just blew my mind. Going out there and seeing the kind of idea-driven work, just there was no going back. The idea of getting ideas into art and then writing about it,
a larger field of art making and curation became
something that I became really interested in. So I've decided to be a painter primarily. I've decided to work in realism, full of ideas around Métis identity,
being Indigenous in the academy,
Indigenous ways of knowing and being.
I'm trying to get that all in a still life painting.
And if I'm not able to realize the idea in a painting,
then I can work on writing,
scripting something for a video or performance.
It's just this restless energy that motivates me more than anything else.
The fate of writers and thinkers is that when their ideas are understood and absorbed, they sort of fade away, and the idea is the thing that's important.
That's way more important. I'd rather have changed somebody's mind than have them pay attention to me.
I don't like attention.
I don't like
public speaking. I don't like
this. I don't like being recorded on camera. I can't stand
it. I'd rather be known for a good turn of phrase that changes your
mind.
Or
a picture that helps summarize some of your thoughts and feelings.
A lot of people have known me by my writing, but I've never published my own book.
Those people tend not to know me as a painter,
and the ones who know me as a painter may not know my work as a curator.
I think what this award does is maybe focuses
people's attentions on this myriad aspects of what I've done, and to be heard on these multiple levels has just been the great privilege of my life.